Write the equation of the line tangent to the graph blank at 1. So to do this, we want to find the derivative at 1 and the value at 1. So we're going to have to do both. So let's just find the value at 1 first. That's a lot easier. To get the equation of the line tangent, don't we first want to plug in just 1? Okay, when we do that, we'll get 3 times, it looks like 9 squared, which is 81. And 3 times 81, what do we got there? 243. So what that tells us is we have a coordinate, 1, 243. That's a pretty high coordinate. That's my coordinate. All right, that's not the answer, but that's a coordinate, x, y. All right, now we have to find the derivative so we can find the slope at 1. So to do the derivative here, do you notice it's a product rule? So g prime x is going to equal, the derivative of 3x is 3. All right, we're going to leave the 5x squared plus 4 squared plus leave the 3x and take the derivative of this piece. So here's, we got a chain rule. We got a chain rule involved. So we take, put the 2 out front. We get 5x squared plus 4, drop the power by 1, and then we take the derivative of the inside, which becomes 10x. Let's take a look. Does that look okay? Did we take the derivative of the front, leave the back, plus leave the front, take the derivative of the back? Now, do we have to clean this up? No, because aren't we plugging in 1 now? So if you want to clean it up, you can, but there's really no need to clean it up. So as we plug in 1, g prime of 1, we have 3 times something squared. And we plug in 1, isn't that going to end up being, actually, let me erase that. If I do that, I kind of do it kind of quick. Isn't that going to be 81? Because if you think about it, put in a 1, that becomes 9 squared. And then the next one becomes 3. Okay, because 3 times 1 is 3. And then the last piece, this might take me a second. I have a 2 times, put a 1 in, that'd be 9. Put a 1 in, that'd be 10. So that looks like what we have so far. We're getting big numbers. It's kind of obnoxious, I know, sorry. This piece we did earlier is 243. And if you multiply the next part, I'll just do that real quick. I did it on another piece of paper, but it's 546. And then when you add both those, g prime 1 is equal to 7. No, I did it wrong. Oops, that is a 40. So your answer would be 783 for your slope. Okay? Then we put them both together. So we're going to use this and this up here. So let's make the equation of the tangent line. Y minus y, which is 243, equals 783. That is very steep. X minus 1. There is your equation for your tangent line for this specific problem. Really big outputs. Luckily it was a 1. Think if we had to put in like 8. This would be extremely steep problem. The table below gives values for f, f prime, g, and g prime for select values of x. So f of 0 is 5. F prime 2 is 8. G of 5 is 4, and so forth. G prime of 2 is 5. You got to get used to this table. All right, it conglomerated a whole bunch of values into a table. These are your x values, and when you plug in those, you got it. So h of x is this. Find h prime 2. So to do that, then we have to first find h prime. So isn't this really just a chain rule? So let's think about that. Isn't h prime of x simply going to be equal to, take the derivative of the outside, leave the inside, take the derivative of the inside. So won't that simply mean f prime g of 2 times g prime of 2. Just think about that. Aren't we putting 2 into here, here, and here? So, what do we do now? We look at the chart. What is g of 2? G of 2 is 0. So what that means is this now becomes g prime of 0 times, what's g prime of 2? So g prime of 2 is 5. So this would be 5. All right, and next, okay, I got 5 here, but what's g prime, what's f prime 0? F prime 0, so f prime 0 is negative 7. F prime 0 is negative 7. So really, what we got here is a negative 7 times 5, so my answer is negative 35. That would be the answer for A. Okay, let's do this one. I want A of x, so A prime of 2. So isn't A just g of f of x? So for that one, isn't it just going to be g prime of f of x times f prime of x? But aren't we now going to, instead of x's, aren't we now going to plug in 2's? Are there actually going to be 2's there? Because it's 2. So can we look at the function? What's f of 2? F of 2 is 0. F of 2 is 0. So what we have there is g prime of 0 times... What's f prime 2? So f prime 2 is 8. F prime 2 is 8. So that would mean this is 8. Because again, f prime 2 is 8. F of 2 is 0. Lastly, what's g prime 0? So g prime 0 is negative 4. So what we now have is this be negative 4 times 8, which is negative 32. So, A prime 2 is negative 32, H prime 2 is negative 35, using this chart for the values that are missing. These are simply just composite functions using chain rule.